It was last June. It was just after the Iran election. You remember what happened on Twitter, on Facebook, on YouTube after the Iran election. And so, yeah, I don't have to tell you why. We decided, we hoped that the person, the first ambassador of the campaign could be Shirin Ebadi. And I cannot tell you my joy when I received an email with an answer. She was accepting to be our first ambassador. She was with us in Milan at the launching day of the campaign on November 21st. She's here today. Please, Shirin, come on the stage with me. Come to help me. And Shirin also is going to be the interpreter. She's a real Nobel Prize, Peace Prize winner. She's a real Nobel Peace Prize winner, not the internet. I don't know if you are going to win it. I want to show you a video, what happened in Milan 10 months ago. It's just 20 seconds clip. Can we have it? I don't know, probably. You've never seen it before. Imagine all the
people. Grazie per la vostra solidarietà ai giovani, al popolo iraniano. Senz'altro l'internet supererà la censura. Vi ringrazio per essere solidari.
We are delighted to be part of this, and you couldn't have picked a better theme, a better time, a better occasion to celebrate the power of the internet. Congratulations.
Probably you recognize Chris Anderson, my great friend Chris Anderson, Wired US editor. He was today connected thanks to Skype from San Francisco. Today he's in Oslo. I don't think he's already making a reservation for a seat for the Nobel ceremony, but you never know. And I want to thank Chris Anderson, David Rowan, the editor of Wired UK, that has been supporting the campaign with me. Now, Shirin, it's up to you.
خیلی ممنونم ریکاردو و همه شمایی که اینجا آمدید و طی این 10 ماه گذشته با این پروژه همکاری کردید. از همتون سپاسگزارم.
Thank you very much, Ricardo, and I want to thank each and every person who has attended this meeting and all of the people who have supported this project.
و ممنونم از اینکه شما اینجا امروز توی سالن هستید و شاهد برنامه اختتامیه کمپین هستید.
And today, which is the last day of the campaign, I want to thank you again for being here and being part of the last day of the campaign.
من امروز میخوام به عنوان یک شاهد براتون صحبت کنم.
Today I want to speak as a witness.
من میخوام شهادت بدم.
I want to testify today.
من میخوام شهادت بدم که اینترنت چقدر به کشور ما کمک کرد.
I want to testify to the fact that the internet has been a great help to my country.
بعد از انتخابات ریاست جمهوری ایران که در سال 2009 در ماه جون اتفاق افتاد، مردم به نتیجه انتخابات معترض بودند، میگفتند تقلب شده.
After the 2009 elections in Iran, which took place in June of 2009, people were angry at the results of the elections. They objected to the results and thought that there was fraud involved.
و در یک راهپیمایی چند میلیونی بسیار مسالمت‌آمیز به خیابان آمدند تا اعتراض خودشون رو بیان کنند.
A few million people took onto the streets and in peaceful demonstrations stated their opposition.
رئیس جمهور که الان هم در نیویورک حضور داره و در مجمع عمومی سازمان ملل مدعی است که ایران بهترین و آزادترین کشور دنیاست، دستور داد که هر کس تو خیابونه تیراندازی بهش بشه.
The president, who happens to be in New York today and who claims that Iran is one of the freest countries in the world, ordered that people be shot at, the ones who were on the streets.
تعدادی کشته شدند، تعدادی زخمی شدند و تعداد بسیار زیادی هم دستگیر شدند.
Some were killed, some were injured, and a big number were arrested.
خبرنگارای خارجی رو فوراً اخراج کردند و تعداد زیادی خبرنگار ایرانی دستگیر شد.
Foreign journalists were expelled right away and a huge number of Iranian journalists were apprehended as well.
چنانی که طبق گزارش گزارشگران بدون مرز در سال 2009 و تا به امروز تا سال 2010 ایران بیشترین تعداد خبرنگاران زندانی رو در جهان داره.
Pursuant to the statistics of Journalists Without Borders, Iran has the most number of journalists in prison at this time.
و هدف از همه این کارها این بود که آنچه که در داخل ایران میگذره به گوش مردم دنیا نرسه.
The goal of the government was to stop the people of the world from understanding and hearing what goes on in Iran.
تلفن ها در خیلی از مناطق شرق قطع شد، موبایل ها را قطع کردن.
Most of the telephones and the cell phones were cut off.
و در این شرایط اینترنت بود که به کمک مردم آمد.
And under these conditions it was the internet that helped the people.
در غیاب خبرنگاران خارجی که اخراج شده بودند و خبرنگاران ایرانی که در زندان بودند، هر کس تبدیل به یک خبرنگار شد.
In the absence of foreign journalists who had been expelled and Iranian journalists who were in prison, each person became a journalist himself or herself.
با موبایلایی که داشتن فیلم می‌گرفتن از خشونت‌های دولتی و ظرف 5 دقیقه به وسیله اینترنت در سراسر دنیا پخش می‌شد.
People used their mobile phones and shot videos and films from the vilest of the government and in 5 minutes or so all over the world such videos and films could be seen.
که چند تا از این فیلم‌هایی که با موبایل گرفته شد در فستیوال‌های مختلف برنده جایزه فیلم‌های خبری شد.
And some of the videos that had been taken by mobile phones won prizes for newsworthy films in different international festivals.
اگر این اتفاق 15 سال قبل افتاده بود، مردم مظلومانه کشته می‌شدند و هیچ کس خبردار نمی‌شد.
Had this happened 15 years prior, people would have been killed, not being guilty, and no one would have known around the world.
اما الان به خاطر وجود اینترنت تمام دنیا متوجه ایرانه و به همین دلیل چندین قطعنامه هم در سازمان ملل و نهادهای بین‌المللی علیه دولت ایران صادر شد که چرا انقدر نقض حقوق بشر میکنه.
But at this time, due to the presence of the internet, the whole world found out what went on in Iran, and a few resolutions were passed by the Security Council of the United Nations regarding the violence of the government.
و به خاطر اینترنت مردمی که از ایران بیرون آمدند تونستند با همدیگه و با داخل کشور در ارتباط باشند و یک شبکه گسترده‌ای از آزادی خواهان رو تشکیل بدن.
And again, due to the presence of the internet, the people who live in exile, the Iranian people who had left the country and live in exile, and those who still remain in the country could get in touch together and form a network of opposition to the government.
و به خاطر وجود اینترنت که شبکه دموکراسی خواهی در ایران روز به روز داره قوی تر میشه.
And it's again due to the presence of the internet that the network of bringing democracy to Iran is becoming stronger and stronger every day.
و کسانی که تاریخ اینترنت رو می‌نویسن به یاد خواهند آورد که اینترنت چطور مردم ایران رو کمک کرد.
And those who are writing the history of the internet will always remember how the internet helped the people of Iran.
و این یک شهادتی است برای آن تاریخ نویسان.
And this is my testification for those who are writing the history.
و به همین دلیل که من از برنامه کاندید کردن اینترنت برای جایزه صلح حمایت میکنم.
And this is why I support the nomination of the internet to receive the Nobel Peace Prize.
و متشکرم از همه دانشمندانی که برای رسیدن اینترنت به این درجه از پیشرفت کمک کردند.
And I also want to thank all the scientists who have helped bring internet to this level of expansion.
تعداد اونها خیلی زیاده که من نمیتونم همه رو نام ببرم.
Of course they're numerous and I cannot name everyone.
ولیکن بشریت مدیون اونها خواهد بود.
But humanity owes them.
امیدوارم که کمیته نوبل با یک انتخاب درست امسال احترام بگذاره به خواست اکثریت مردم.
And I hope that the Nobel Committee will pick the right nominee and respect the demand of the people.
کمیته نوبل در یک رئیس کمیته نوبل در یک مصاحبه اعلام کرده بود که تا به الان هیچ کاندیدایی اینقدر ازش طرفداری نشده بود که از اینترنت طرفداری شده.
The head of the Nobel Committee had announced in an interview that no other nominee has had the support that the internet nomination has had.
و من امیدوارم روز 10 دسامبر 2010 که روز اعطای جایزه صلح نوبل همه ماها جشن بگیریم برای اینکه کاندیدمون برنده شده.
And I hope that on December 10th when the Nobel Peace Prize is being given out we can all celebrate for the internet which will win.
موفق باشید.
I wish you success.
Thank you. Thank you. Grazie. Grazie, and I will keep following your battles for human rights worldwide. And I wish you good luck for you and for your country. All the best, and please, are you for freedom very soon? Thank you.